Cyclotron is a device which we use to get very high velocity or very high energy charged particle. A device, and we need it for what? We need it for experiments in nuclear physics. Now, what is the principle we are going to use to get high energy, high velocity charged particle? Very simple. Here is an electric field between these two plates. Electric field in this direction. A charged particle which is here gets a force that is equal to QE, and because of this force it has an acceleration which is QE upon M. Okay, this is the acceleration. Because of this acceleration, its velocity goes on increasing, and how much it become? This velocity is equal to U plus AT. If U is 0, then it is QE upon M into T. So this velocity will go on increasing if electric field is strong or if time is very large. If we want a large time, then this gap has to be very large, and if we make this gap very large, then we apply a potential difference here. Here we apply a potential difference V, and this is a very small length L. So how much is E? E is equal to V upon L. If we increase this L, then this E will become weak because L2 is large. If L2 is large, E2 will become weak. If E2 become weak, then velocity will become less. So this T we cannot increase. T has to be short. But if T has to be short, then velocity will be less, because we are giving the force very small time to get accelerated. We should give more time to get it accelerated. Then it will accelerate and its velocity will increase. So in a small gap, we have a problem that if we increase the gap to get more travel time, electric field become weak. If we decrease the gap to make electric field very strong, then we don't get much time. So how can we increase the speed? How can we increase the speed to a large extent? So we got a solution. The solution is, take one charged particle here, increase its speed from here 0 to V. Again, take this charged particle by some method, again pass it here. Now from V it will increase to 2V. Take this particle back here, again pass through this path where we have electric field. Here it will become 3V. Again take it here, 3V. Pass through this, this will become 4V, and do it for 1000 times. If you do it for 1000 times, then at the end what you will get? You will get the charged particle with a speed of 1000V. And if 1000V is the speed, then its energy, half mv square, will be phenomenal, very large. But here what we are doing, passing through electric field, bringing it back to electric field, bringing it back to electric field, bringing it back to electric field, passing through again, and this is a very strong electric field because this length we have kept very small. So we can increase the speed of a charged particle to a very large extent if we have a method to pass the charge again and again from the same electric field. Okay, now how to do that? And to do that, we have a device which is cyclotron. So in this, how do we turn it and bring it here? We have just been learning that a charged particle can be turned. this. It is going in this direction, now it is going in this direction. How can we turn it? You have just learnt it. If there is a magnetic field B and we allow the charge particle to pass through this, this will turn, make a circular motion. Half circle, then again half circle. So we can always turn. We can always turn an charge particle with help of a magnetic field. And then once again, we can ask this charge particle to enter the electric field. So, electric field will accelerate. A magnetic field will bring it back to the electric field. Again, electric field will accelerate. Magnetic field, again turn it and come back to the electric field. This is the arrangement we make in cyclotron. And this is what we mentioned in its principle. So if I write its principle here, I will write it this way. On what principle cyclotron work? Principle. This is introduction. This is principle. These are the two principles involving electric field and magnetic field, which will increase the velocity number of times. Now, we come to what is the description? Description of a cyclotron. It is a small device which is just like a metallic tiffin box, a round tiffin box. We have, if we see it from the top, it will appear like this. A round tiffin box. Yes, this way. And this round tiffin box, we cut from the center, we cut it from here. If we cut it from here, we get two half circular boxes like this. Okay. We have these two half circular boxes and each appears like a D. So we give them the name D's. So there are two D's and these two D's are placed horizontally. If there is one D like this, its face is here. There is another D like this and its face is here. These are the two faces which are opposite to each other. So if a charge particle comes out from here, it will enter this face like this. And this is half circle, this is half circle. Inside hollow like this. So this is what we make a cyclotron. So from the top, I will make it like this. Simple. Here is the gap. Okay. Hollow inside. These two metallics are connected with a electrical source. We will call it oscillating device because the electric field we are making or the electric supply we are giving is a oscillating supply. Once this becomes plus and minus, then this becomes minus, this becomes plus. So this is the sign of AC and this AC is given here. This is called oscillating supply and this device is known as oscillator. This is oscillator. This oscillator operates at a very high volt, say 10 to the power 4 volt, that is what we can give. And it has oscillating frequency. That frequency is adjustable, it can go up to 10 to the power 6 hertz. So many times in 1 second, it can change its polarity. We can adjust it to our desired value. Okay, that means if we want, this will become plus, and this will become minus, and just at the other instant, this will become minus and this will become plus. That means at one time, for half of this cycle, electric field will be in this direction, and for other half of this cycle, electric field will be in this direction, again in this direction, in this direction. So see this gap. Inside the gap, there will always be electric field, but this electric field is oscillating. Once it is in this direction, then it is in this direction, and in 1 second, it will change its direction 10 to the power 6 times. So much. So this is D's and oscillator system. Then this whole pot, this whole device, which is a horizontal device, is kept between two magnets. I can make it this way, that if this is our cyclotron, now this is a side view, then here is a magnet this way, and here is magnetic pole, let us say north-south. So there will be a strong magnetic field here. So this whole box is under effect of a magnetic field like this. This has got two parts, one D, other D. There is a gap between the two. So this is cyclotron. This is top view, this is side view. These are connected with oscillator. This can create an electric field, and these magnets, strong electromagnets, can create magnetic field. So in description, what are the main components? Two D's, hollow metal pots with gap. Then we have oscillator 10 to the power 4 volt, 10 to the power 6 hertz oscillating supply. Oscillating potential difference, that is given here. Okay, then C, we have a strong magnetic field. I will write it here. C, magnets to create magnetic field normal to cyclotron. This is cyclotron side view. These are two electromagnets, and they create a magnetic field across it. When we start the electricity, then magnetism start here, and there is a magnetic field across. That means if we have a cyclotron in this way, this, then this is the magnetic field like this, and here it goes like this, normal to the plane of cyclotron, this way. Okay, now next D. We need a source of positive charge, that is source of ion. I am keeping here. This is a source of ion. This is normally a heater. So whenever we heat it up, then ions are projected out and ions are released from this point. So this is source of ion. All these instruments, this device is kept in a box, that is vacuum box, evacuated cover. This whole thing is in an evacuated cover, so that from outside no air can pass through it. Okay. Then we have a target where we want to hit, where we are doing the experiment of nuclear physics. That is this point, we call it target, and from here finally the excited or accelerated particle with lot of energy will go and hit the target. Okay, so this is the description. Now after this description, we come to working of it. How does it work? See, we will start working. Okay. Number one, we start this heater. A positive ion is released. The moment ion is released, it is in the gap here. It gets accelerated due to electric field E, experience a force QE and get an acceleration QE upon M. Due to this acceleration, its velocity goes on increasing, and here it enters the D. The moment it enters the D, inside the box, electric field is zero because of electrostatic shielding. This we have done, that inside electrostatic shielding, and because of that electric field is zero. Okay, if electric field is zero, the acceleration stops. But magnetic field is not zero, magnetic field is all through it. Now see, this is magnetic field. A charge is entering here, then what will happen? It will start making a circle. This electric charge start making a circle in this. After making half the circle, it again appear in the gap. But now it appears from right and it is going towards left. During the same time, this time, this oscillator has changed the polarity. Now this has become plus and this has become minus. Earlier this was plus, this was minus, this was direction of electric field. Now when it comes here, it has taken some time. During this time it has changed the polarity. This has become plus, this has become minus, and now electric field is in this direction. If now electric field is in this direction and the charge is also coming in this direction, it will experience a force in which direction? In direction of electric field. This force it experiences, this is direction of electric field. So if its velocity and electric field are in the same direction, it will experience force in this direction and its velocity will go on increasing. Here which was 1V, it will increase, say it has become 2V by the time it reaches here. So from here it gets accelerated and cross this. Here he find that the E is in the same direction, so it gets accelerated. From V it become 2V. The moment he enters the D1, this is D1, this is D2. It enters D1, inside no electric field, E is zero inside, but magnetic field is there. Again same thing happens, there is a magnetic field, the charge enters and it makes a circle. It makes a circle and go like this. After making half the circle, it appears in the gap again. When it appears in the gap, then it takes from here to here some time, and during this time, this oscillator has again make a half circle. Half circle means this has become positive, this has become negative, and now once again electric field is in this direction. And this charge after doing half the circle has come here. This is velocity of the charge, this is electric field, this is direction of the force in the direction of velocity. So the velocity goes on increasing. This passes through this and this velocity 2V now become 3V. The moment it enters this D, again electric field stops, and because of magnetic field it makes half the circle, and by the time it reaches this gap, the electric field changes in this direction, and because of this electric field its velocity increases, and from 3V it becomes 4V. Now it goes here, electric field is like that, it becomes 5V, 6V, 7V, like this it goes on increasing. And every time its radius also keeps on increasing. Why radius keeps on increasing? Because for the radius you have a formula. For the radius you did a formula, and that was, what was that? C mv square upon r, this was equal to qvb. Vv cancelled and r is equal to, radius is equal to mv upon qb. Because the velocity has become 2v, then 3v, this velocity goes on increasing. So what will happen to radius? Radius is also increased. So when the velocity is 2v, radius becomes large, 3v, large, 4v, larger, larger, larger. So this becomes a spiral shape. Now, this radius goes on increasing, and every time velocity goes on increasing, both are increasing. By the time this radius becomes equal to radius of the cyclotron. Now, we cannot increase it any further. So here we make a window, and from this window we make a tunnel here, give it a negative charge. So this positive charge gets a negative charge here, and with all its velocity and energy it shoots out. But because of inertia it does not go here or there, it just goes straight and hit the target with a very high velocity. This is working of it. So in this, what we are doing? Accelerating the charge in the electric field gap, again bringing it back to the gap with help of magnetic field, again accelerating it, again bringing it back to the electric field. So every time acceleration is done by electric field, but it is brought back to the electric field by magnetic field by turning it. So hundreds of times, thousands of times we increase the velocity, and finally we take it out with a high velocity. This is how it works. So this is its working. So working, we can write it in brief. Okay, now see this. Charges generated at source S is accelerated due to electric field in the gap. With increased velocity it enters D2 there. Inside there is no electric field, hence magnetic field is prominent. This magnetic field turns it back to the gap. By this time polarity of E at the gap is reversed by oscillator, and it becomes along V. So velocity increase further when it enters D1. This way velocity keeps on increasing. With this, radius also increase due to this relation. R is equal to mv upon qb. Now what happens after this? I will write it here. So therefore it makes a spiral shape. When radius is equal to the radius of D, then it is, radius is maximum. The kinetic energy and velocity both are maximum. Now it is allowed to move out and hit the target at the last. So what I explained you, this has been written here. Okay, this was working. So it hits the target. Now relations. We have done the relations earlier. The same relations we will repeat here. Centripetal force QVB was equal to mv square upon r, and this gives us the relations. What is that relation? First, radius is equal to mv upon qb. Velocity is equal to qrb upon m. V is equal to r omega, so omega, angular velocity, is independent of radius, that is r omega, r is cancelled, So this is QB upon M, angular velocity. Then time period. Time period is equal to 2 pi m upon qb. Time period, how do we get? Omega is equal to 2 pi upon t. If we want frequency, then 2 pi nu. Frequency, number of cycles per second, that is equal to qb upon 2 pi m. Then its kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is equal to 2m q square b square and r square. Velocity is square, q square, r square, b square. Half, okay, this is yes. So these are the relations of it. With these relations, we have certain questions to ask. Number one, for the first circle and the last circle, is the time period same? Answer yes, it is same, because M, Q, B, all these three things are not changing. Okay, then frequency also remains same, and this is frequency which is decided by Q, M and B, and we fix our oscillator with this frequency. So this is also known as cyclotron frequency. Cyclotron frequency. Okay, so these are the relations, and this is the finally kinetic energy of that particle. Now, kinetic energy depends upon which field? Is it electric field or magnetic field? Answer, it is magnetic field. You see, the velocity is again due to which field? Answer, magnetic field. Why? The velocity is due to acceleration and acceleration is due to electric field. Then why this magnetic field appear here? The answer is because stronger is the magnetic field, more will be the number of times it is pulled or it is pushed into the gap. Therefore, stronger is the magnetic field, more will be the rounds, and the final velocity will keep on increasing. So these are the relations of cyclotron. After this, we have got this device which will increase the energy and velocity. But can we do all the things with this, or there are certain limitations? So answer, there are certain limitations. There are few jobs which cannot be done by the cyclotron, and that is known as limitations. So now we will see what is limitation, what are the limitations in cyclotron. So number 6 in cyclotron description is limitation. Cannot work on neutrons. Why? Because Q for neutron is 0. If there is no charge, there will be no force, because the force is Q into E. There is no force, there will be no acceleration. If there is no acceleration, velocity will not increase. So it cannot work on neutron. Then a very important limitation of this, if we go on increasing the velocity, how much we can increase? Can we go on increasing? Answer, no, we cannot increase it much. Why? Because of the fact, and that fact you have to understand, that when it enters the gap, the electric field and velocity both should be in the same direction, then only velocity will increase. Suppose the particle enters with this velocity in this direction, but at that time electric field is in this direction, then there will be force in this direction, and that will act as retarding force or the brake on this charged particle, and its velocity will decrease. So it is necessary that velocity and electric field both should come to one direction, and when velocity comes here, then electric field should also be in the same direction. That is known as synchronization. Okay. That is, the steps are matching. So we call it instep. Instep means both are coming together. For that, what is necessary? Answer, for that, time period is necessary. That time period, oscillator time period, we are setting manually by hand. And that calculation we are doing with that what? That calculation we are doing with this expression, 2 pi m upon b. Here, if our particle is, say, helium nucleus, then we will take the mass of helium nucleus, charge of helium nucleus, we will calculate the time period with help of b, and according to that time period we will set up the time of oscillator, so that when it completes half the circle, at the same time oscillator will change the electric field. So electric field change by oscillator and rotation of the charged particle, they should be synchronized, they should have the same time. This is calculation by parameters of the charged particle, and this time we apply here manually. Okay, now this manual will not change, it will keep like that, but what happens to this time period of rotation of the charged particle? When its velocity goes on increasing, there will be certain changes. What are those changes? Changes are this m change. And if this m change, this m become more, larger, then the time will become more. Why this m will become more? So, limitation according to Einstein's, according to Einstein equation, the mass of a particle in motion is equal to its mass at rest divided by root of 1 minus v square upon c square. Now, this is what? This is mass of a moving particle. This is a moving particle. Normally, this velocity and velocity of light. Velocity of light is very large compared to this. So, this becomes 0. If this becomes 0, then mv is equal to m0. No change. But when this velocity becomes very high, let us say 1/4 of the c, then this denominator decrease and this velocity increase in the mass at velocity is significant. We are able to experience that there is certain change in the mass. So at high v, at high velocity, mass increase. If at high velocity mass increase, then what will happen to time? Time also increase. Synchronization is disturbed. They go out of step. Charged particle and electric field created by oscillator, they go out of step, means when this is coming here, electric field become like this because it is already delayed. The time period has increased. They go out of step. And if they go out of step, what will happen? This will get retarded. No further acceleration. No further acceleration. This is limit of increasing the velocity. We cannot increase velocity more than this. We cannot. I will write it here. That is our limitation. We cannot increase velocity beyond this level. Hence, this is limitation. So, this is limitation in cyclotron, that velocity can be increased to a fixed level, and after that the mass will become more and their synchronization is disturbed and we cannot increase it anymore. That is why cyclotrons are small, 6 inches, 10 inches, 12 inches, like that. Not more than that, not very large. For that we have a different type of accelerators, and that is nowadays we are using. But here our purpose is only to find out the principle, only to understand the principle how a charged particle can be accelerated.